poor, hard, toiling, ill-provided man. Careless of what vulgar men toil for. He's not worried about things that men, vulgar men toil for. Not a bad man, I should say. Something better in him than hunger of any sort. Or these wild Arab men fighting and jostling 23 years at his hand, in close contact with him always, would not have reverenced him so. They were wild men. These Arabs, they said they were wild men, bursting ever and anon into quarrel, into all kinds of fierce sincerity, without right worth and manhood. No man could have commanded them. Without that quality of sincerity, integrity, manhood, he said, no man could have commanded them. They called him prophet, you say. He says, why? He stood there face to face with them, bare, not enshrined in any mystery, visibly clouting his own clothes, cobbling his own shoes, fighting, counseling, ordering in the midst of them. They must have seen what kind of a man he was. Let him be called what you like. Call him what you like. No emperor with his tiaras was obeyed as this man in a cloak of his own clouting. During 23 years of rough actual trial, I find something of a veritable hero necessary for that of itself. Our Muslim describes it, that Mard-e Kamil, that perfect man. Allah says, لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنًا. So most certainly in the Apostle of Allah, you have the best exemplar. This is in 1840. 14 years later, in 1854, a Frenchman writes a history of the Turks by the name of Lamartine, a Frenchman. And incidentally, the Turks being Muslims, so he starts speaking about our Nabi. He says something. And he gives us three other objective standards. Now this is something great about the Westerner. He's looking for angles which we didn't think before. Jews Masterman, he says, now those three qualities. This man is talking about other three qualities. And his qualities he's giving is, he says, number one, if greatness of purpose, what the man is out to do. وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ. Allah says, we have not sent you, but as a mercy unto the whole of mankind, the whole universal man. Alameen, of the worlds. Alam means the world, and alameen means the worlds, not only physical world, spiritual world, every type of creation. وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ. That's his purpose in life, as a mercy unto the whole of mankind. Not for Jews, or not for Hindus, or Arya Samaj, he is for the whole of mankind. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. This is how he starts. All praise is due to Allah, the Lord and Cherisher of the worlds, not of the Arabs, or the Pakistanis, or the Malaysians. No. Alameen. Greatness of purpose, smallness of means. You know how he starts? Before he is born, his father dies. By the time he's six, his mother dies. His grandfather starts looking after the little infant child, and before long, grandfather dies. Then by the time he's 12, his uncle Abu Talib's goats is looking after. This is the beginning, smallness of means. No political party to back him up. No royalty to back him up. It's one man against all men. One man against the whole world. Nobody, his own people were not prepared to receive his message. From the word go, trials and tribulations, you know his history. Smallness of means and outstanding results. Today, 1,000 million Muslims. Christianity boasts 1,200 million. But they had 600 years, they were ahead of us. But an American, in his book, The Messenger, Bodley, in his book, The Messenger, he says, that there are more professing Christians in the world than professing Muslims. Professing mean people who fill census forms. So what religion you belong to? Even if he's an atheist, he will say Christian. He won't say Jew because he's not a Jew. He won't say Hindu because he's not a Hindu. he was a Christian. You know, coming from a Christian background, he says Christian. So from that point of view, there are more Christians in the world today. There are more professing people who say with the lips. There are more professing Christians than professing Muslims. But there are more practicing Muslims in the world than practicing Christians. People who practice the religion. Alhamdulillah. There are more Muslims who practice. We have our shortcomings. But as a people as a whole, there are more practicing Muslims in the world today than practicing Christians. This is what Bodley says in his book, The Messenger. Outstanding results are the three criteria of human genius. So who could dare to compare any great man in modern history with Muhammad? He dares. Bring your candidate. Any man, bring him. Compare with this man, Muhammad. Who could dare to compare? He is daring you. Bring yours to compare with this man. This is the most famous men, talking about others, created armies, laws and empires only. They founded, if anything at all, no more than material powers, which often crumbled away before their eyes, like Hitler's power. Crumbled away before his own eyes. Mussolini's power crumbled away before his eyes. Mikado's Japan crumbled away before his very eyes. Crumbled away before their eyes. This man, Muhammad, is a moved not only armies, legislations, empires, peoples and dynasties, but millions of men. And more than that, he moved the gods of the people, he moved them out of the way. The gods, the religions, the ideas, the beliefs, and the souls. And he ends his beautiful tribute by saying, philosopher, orator, apostle, legislator, warrior, conqueror of ideas, the restorer of rational beliefs, of a cult without images, the founder of 20 terrestrial empires and of one spiritual empire. That is Muhammad. That is Muhammad. With regards to all standards whereby human greatness may be measured, we may well ask, is there any man greater than he?